वैल्यूएशन ऑफ स्पाइनल ट्यूबरकुलोसिस ऑन 3 टेस्ला एमआरआई ए केस स्टडी पॉट्स डिजीज ए ट्यूबरकुलर इन्फेक्शन ऑफ स्पाइन वाज फर्स्ट डिस्क्राइब्ड बाय इन 1779 बाय पर सर्वाइवल पॉट इज द मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज ऑफ नॉन ट्रॉमेटिक पैराप्लेजिया इन द वर्ल्ड द स्पाइनल इन्वॉल्वमेंट इज यूजुअली रिजल्ट ऑफ हेमाटोजेनस स्प्रेड ऑफ माइकोबैक्टीरियम टीबी वाय रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक और इंटेस्टीन इन टू द डेंस वेस्कुलेचर ऑफ कैंसिलस बोन्स ऑफ वर्टिब्रल बॉडीज इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ आईबीडी रिजल्ट्स इन लॉस ऑफ डिस्क हाइट एंड कोलैप्स ऑफ वर्टिब्रल बॉडी रिजल्ट इन शार्प एंगुलेशन कॉल्ड एज काइफस According to WHO in 2006, nearly 2 billion people, about one-third of world's population, had tuberculosis. Spinal TB accounts for 2% of all TB cases, 15% of all cases of extrapulmonary TB, and 50% of skeletal TB. The clinical presentation of TB spine is variable and insidious in onset. The most common symptom of all being low packing. Constitutional symptoms such as loss of weight, anorexia, low-grade fever, and malaise are more commonly associated with pulmonary TB than with spinal TB. Plain X-ray, CT, and MRI are the prime modalities to assess the pot spine. There must be at least 30% destruction of bone mineral loss is needed to show the radiolucency on X-ray. CT is an excellent tool for delineating bony details. However, it is inferior to MR for early assessment of neural structures as well as soft tissue extension. So it is not preferred due to radiation exposure. MRI provides excellent details of neural as well as soft tissue extension in spinal TB, therefore beneficial for early diagnosis as well as planning management. Aim of the study is to study the role of 3 Tesla MRI in evaluation of spinal tuberculosis. Objectives: to describe the pattern of occurrence of TB, spinal TB on MRI, to evaluate the role of MRI in assessing the extent of disease and its correlation with the neurological status of patient of spinal TB. The study was done in Department of Radiodiagnostics and Imaging, PT BT Sharma, PJMS, Rohtak. 85 patients were taken irrespective of age and sex who were clinically suspected or diagnosed cases of TB. Inclusion criteria is all clinically suspected or diagnosed cases of spinal TB. Exclusion criteria is previously operated or completely treated patients of spinal TB, any metallic implants, claustrophobia, and traumatic and degenerative cases. Parameters to be taken: T1 weighted sagittal and axial, T2 weighted sagittal and axial images, stir sagittal images, and post contrast images. Results: the study was carried out on 85 patients, out of which 49 were male and 36 were females. The mean age of subjects was 37.2 years. Maximum number of patients were between age group of 20 to 30 years. The most common symptoms in this series were backache, which was present in 73 out of 85 patients. 85% patient had constitutional symptoms. Neurological involvement in the form of foot pain was present in 32 patients, whereas paresis was present in 23 patients. ESR was raised in 82 out of 85 patients. Montu was done in all 85 patients, found to be positive in 75 of them. Chest X-ray was taken in all patients, PA view. It revealed associated pulmonary TB in 27 patients. Plain X-ray finding were abnormal in 72 out of 85 patients. Involvement of body was present in 66 out of 85 patients. Typical picture of tuberculosis spine, that is paradiscal, was present in 18 out of 85 patients. Osteitis was seen as T1 hypointensity and T2 hyperintensity. On T1 images, 74 out of 85 patients showed hypointense signal and 80% patients showed hyperintense signal on T2 weighted images. Stir sequence, 87 patients shows hyperintense signal intensity. 53 out of 80 patients showed for peripheral enhancement. Maximum number of vertebrae involved in a single patient were 14. Minimum were one vertebrae in a single patient. On MR imaging, average number of vertebrae involvement was 3. Lumbar spine was the most common site of involvement seen in present study. 36 out of 85 patients showed involvement of lumbar spine. Second most common site was dorsal spine with involvement of 27 out of 85 patients. Least common site was cervicodorsal followed by sacral. 47 out of 85 showed epidural collection. 22 out of 85 showed changes in signal intensity of spinal cord. Case 1, 25-year-old female with chronic fatigue, low-grade fever, and bowel and bladder weakness. First image is the frontal radiograph of sacral spine showing blurring of lumbosacral region. Second image is a T2-weighted SAG showing large prevertebral and anterior epidural collection. Second image, 42-year-old male with chronic low backache with acute onset weakness in bilateral lower limb. First image is non-contiguous involvement of tubercular spine. Second image is the typical peripheral enhancement of collection with enhancement of involved vertebrae. Third case, 6-year-old child with visible deformity of back and unable to walk. First image is the frontal radiograph showing kyphoisolated deformity. Second image is the coronal T1 weighted showing peripheral enhancement of the paravertebral collection. Discussion. The age group of patient ranged from 2 to 88 years, with mean age of subject was 37.2 years. The study population showed slight male predominance with 42.4% female and 57% male. Similar observation was seen in study by Bhatnagar et al. And Sinan et al. In our study, most common presenting symptom was chronic low backache seen in 73 patients. Yandrapati et al. Also reported backache as the most reliable and important history of further workup. 14 out of 26 showed subligamentous spread of infection. Similar results were seen by Antonio Archie. In our study, contiguous pattern of infection in spread is the most common pattern seen in 79 patients. Similar results were reported by Anil et al. And with 95% patients showing contiguous pattern of spread. In present study, common radiographic findings of spine were consistent with spine fluorosis were vertebral body and plate erosion seen in 76.77%. Then Tavir et al. Reported end plate destruction 43% cases. In present study, the most common site of involvement was lumbar spine followed by dorsal spine. Roth et al. Reported two most common sites of involvement were dorsal and lumbosacral spine. In present study, 87.1% cases showed hypointense signal on T1 weighted sequence. T2 hyperintensity is noted in 80% of affected vertebra with hyperintense signal on STIR sequence in 87.1 patients, suggesting adimatous changes due to inflammatory process. These observations comparable to a similar study by Bhatnagar et al. Revealed T1 hypointense signal with hyperintense signal on T2 and STIR. In our study, epidural collection was seen in 47 patients of cases, which was similar to observation by R. Singh et al. Jan A. K. et al. Observed epidural collection in 80% cases with similar finding in study by Anil R. et al. Conclusion. Since MRI is non-invasive, highly sensitive and capable of multiplanar imaging, it should be considered as main imaging modality for suspected tubercular spondylitis, intradural extramedullary tuberculosis, tubercular arachnoiditis, intramedullary tuberculosis. The ability of MRI to detect tuberculosis of spine earlier than other techniques could reduce the bone destruction and deformity and hence need for surgical intervention. I spoke.